Title: Scrolls to Scripture, Bible Revisionist History. Author: J.L. Seaton.
Narrated by Rachael A.I. Introduction. The Bible is full of great stories, from the tales of ancient patriarchs to the parables of Jesus. Even people who don't see it as a religious book appreciate the Bible as a collection of ancient stories. But the Bible itself also has an interesting story. In this journey, you'll learn about the world's most famous, most read, most debated, and sometimes most disliked book. How, when, and why did it come to be? What stages has it gone through? How many versions are there? How has it influenced the world we live in? The Bible's story is long, starting from the first collections of ancient Jewish laws, hundreds of years before the Common Era, to today. Nowadays, Bibles are printed in many languages and can be found almost anywhere around the world, because this is the story of a book. It includes how books are made, starting with the writing and collection of scrolls, then moving to the writing and copying of manuscripts, and the invention of printing. Printing made it possible for everyone to own a Bible. Since the Bible spread worldwide, the story also involves languages and translation. What happened when the original Hebrew of the Torah was translated into Greek, or when the Greek New Testament was translated into Latin and other languages? What new meanings appear, and what old meanings were lost? The story of the Bible is complex. There are actually several Bibles, so there are several stories to tell. Jews and Christians have different collections of writings they call the Bible, and read them in different languages. Different Christian groups also have different collections. Catholic, Orthodox, and Protestant Christians have overlapping but not identical Bibles. The reasons for this diversity and its effects are important, especially since decisions about what to include in the Bible were often disputed, and still are today. The Bible's story also includes how it has been read and interpreted by different religious traditions. Jews and Christians not only read different Bibles, but also interpret them differently. Interpretation is central to Jewish and Christian identities. And the story of the Bible is linked to the history of these religions. Bible interpretation happens through the work of scholars and theologians, and also through worship practices, prayer, poetry, art, and music inspired by the pages of the Bible. We will explore this complex history in four phases. The first phase looks at ancient times, showing how different writings were collected to form the Hebrew Bible and the New Testament. The second phase follows how these texts were transmitted, translated, and interpreted by Jewish and Christian communities during the medieval period. The third phase covers the Protestant Reformation, focusing on the impact of printing and the translation of the Bible into English. The fourth phase discusses the discovery of ancient manuscripts, the creation of critical editions, and the rise of historical scholarship on the Bible, as well as the role of biblical translation around the world. No single book can tell you everything about the Bible, but this one gives a good start on a story that needs to be told because it is both little known and widely misunderstood. End of introduction. Chapter 1. An Ancient Beginning. The Bible is undeniably a powerful book, exerting its influence even when it's not being read. For some, it evokes fear and distrust, while for many others, it stands as the ultimate source of truth. Generally, these emotions often stem not from the Bible's actual content, but rather from its unique status as a book that has profoundly impacted world history. Let's explore the unusual status of the Bible. It transcends the realm of normal literature, carrying a special story that is distinct from the numerous fascinating or frightening narratives found within its pages. The Bible is famous for its many stories, which have greatly influenced Western culture. These stories, both individually and collectively, have shaped our morals, art, and traditions. An Ancient Beginning. The most well-known stories come from the Hebrew Bible and the New Testament. Many people learn these stories as children. The Hebrew Bible is filled with dramatic and emotional tales, while the New Testament includes Jesus' short and powerful parables, as well as vivid accounts of Jesus and his followers. These narratives often teach moral lessons and inspire artists. Beyond these shorter stories, the Bible encompasses epic tales. The story of Abraham and the other patriarchs recounts the ancestors of a people. The story of the Exodus and the conquest illustrates how a nation claimed its land and identity. Jesus' death and resurrection lay the foundation for a new religious identity. Altogether, the Bible can be seen as one grand story, from Genesis to Revelation. Despite some parts of the Bible being difficult and somber, its stories have profoundly impacted Western culture. As a book, or rather a collection of books, the Bible has an intriguing history. It's a publishing marvel, printed more than 5 billion times since 1815 in about 2,100 languages, and is read and misunderstood by more people worldwide than any other book. The Bible's influence extends beyond its words. It's often quoted as an authority, used for oaths, and given special honor and worship. It even symbolizes certain ways of thinking, like biblical religion or the Bible Belt. Telling the story of the Bible as a book involves some tricky questions. When did the Bible first become a book? We need to consider both the origins of the individual writings and how they were compiled. The forms the Bible has taken over time, from scrolls and codices to actual printed books, demonstrate advances in bookmaking. The various versions of the Bible are significant, too. There are differences between the Jewish and Christian Bibles, and even among the many different Christian denominations. Translating the Bible into numerous languages has been crucial for spreading its message and understanding it. Interpreting the Bible is another key aspect of its story. Jewish and Christian traditions have their own methods of interpretation. Modern historical interpretation often clashes with these traditions. Interpretation occurs not just in writing, but in many cultural forms. In this book, we will explore its history in four phases. Phase 1 examines the origins of the Bible's writings and how they were collected. Phase 2 looks at the different versions of the Christian Bible in ancient times and how they were interpreted through the Middle Ages. Phase 3 explores the Bible's story during the Renaissance, Reformation, and Enlightenment. Phase 4 brings the story to modern times, focusing on historical criticism and current responses. By studying each phase, we can understand the Bible's deep and complex influence on culture, religion, and history. The story of the Bible begins with the slow, centuries-long gathering of Hebrew writings in ancient Israel. The early stages of forming the Jewish Bible, known as Tanakh, involved three main parts: T, N, K. This acronym, Tanakh, stands for the Torah, the five books of Moses, Nevi'im, the prophets, and Ketuvim, the writings. These ancient writings, originally inscribed on scrolls, emerged from the needs and activities of the people at different times. Each piece of writing offers us a glimpse into those historical situations, while collectively, they create a clear and impressive story of a people and the God who created the world. Through prophets, God shows how humans should honor him by living rightly in his world. The Hebrew Bible, or Tanakh, is a collection of writings from an ancient people, created over a long period under harsh circumstances. Both Judaism and Christianity believe the Bible is divinely inspired, but also recognize its human and historical origins. This belief in inspiration is more about the authority of the Bible than how it was written. Figuring out its human origins is challenging and involves piecing together different types of evidence and making educated guesses. The Hebrew Bible's stories came from a formerly nomadic people living between Babylon to the east and Egypt to the west. These writings were created over a long period of time and show influences from different stages of ancient Near Eastern culture. The original language was Hebrew, distinct from other languages in the region. The second part of the Book of Daniel is written in Aramaic, a dialect of Hebrew. The Bible was created through both spoken and written traditions. Oral traditions are evident in prophetic literature and psalms, but writing also played a role. Major narratives likely started as oral stories, similar to other cultures' folklore. Writing required skilled scribes serving both the court and the temple. Stable periods, like after Solomon established the court and temple, or after the exile when they were rebuilt, were key times for writing the foundation of the Bible. The most important part of the Hebrew Bible is the Torah, or the five books of Moses. The five books of Moses are Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. While tradition says Moses wrote these books around 1250 BCE, scholars agree they were composed over a long time by multiple authors. In the 19th century, scholars noticed features like double stories and different names for God, suggesting multiple sources. They identify four main sources: the Yahwist, Elohist, Deuteronomist, and priestly sources, each contributing at different times. Genesis covers creation, the fall, and the stories of the patriarchs from Abraham to Joseph. Exodus tells of Israel's enslavement in Egypt, Moses' call, the plagues, the escape from Egypt, and receiving the law. Leviticus focuses on laws, especially those related to worship and sacrifice. Numbers describes the 40 years of wandering in the wilderness, including rebellions and God's miracles. Deuteronomy contains Moses' speeches before entering Canaan, urging obedience and explaining the blessings of following the covenant and the curses of disobedience. The prophets make up the second major part of the Tanakh, consisting of 21 books. Known as the former prophets are six narrative books: Joshua, Judges, 1 and 2 Samuel, 1 and 2 Kings, that continue the story from entering the land. The latter prophets include major prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and minor prophets, 12 shorter books, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. The 13 writings, known as the Writings, are the final and least organized section of the Jewish Bible, divided into 39 composites. Within the writings, there are the ancient Megillot, or scrolls, which include five books: Song of Songs, Ruth, Lamentations, Ecclesiastes, Esther. There is also wisdom literature, which includes Psalms, Proverbs, and Job. Finally, there are the historical books, which include 1 and 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, and Daniel. The Hebrew Bible is a diverse collection that imagines a world created and governed by God Almighty. Its stories, laws, and teachings form a coherent vision that has had a profound impact on Western culture and religious thought to this very day. End of chapter. Chapter 2. The First 100 Years. In the first century CE, the Jewish Bible was a central symbol for Jews around the world, yet it existed in many different forms and interpretations. Judaism itself was diverse and divided, particularly in its response to Hellenistic culture and Roman rule. Different groups of Jews disagreed on which books were considered scripture. They read their texts in various languages, while many in Palestine read Hebrew. Other Jews in both Palestine and the diaspora read scripture in Greek. During this time, various methods of interpreting the Bible also developed. Examining the Dead Sea Scrolls of Qumran reveals just how complex these differences had become. The First 100 Years. Our understanding of Jewish scripture in the first century CE is mostly based upon literary evidence that comes from those scriptures themselves. During this time, Judaism was both united and divided. From the outside, it seemed like a large extended family. But inside, there were many different and competing forms. The term Torah served as a central symbol that united Jews across the Mediterranean world. Torah refers to a shared set of texts, especially the Law of Moses, which were read in worship and study. It also represents a shared story that gave all Jews a sense of identity among the nations. Additionally, Torah signifies a set of fundamental beliefs, such as the belief in one God, God's election of the Hebrew people, and the covenant between God and Hebrew. The Torah includes commandments that outline the responsibilities of the people under this covenant, and Jews everywhere were connected by shared rituals like circumcision, observing the Sabbath, and other moral and ritual obligations. Torah also provided a wisdom or philosophy of life based on these commandments. In the first century CE, Jews in the Mediterranean world were diverse and sometimes divided. More Jews lived outside of Palestine, in the diaspora, than in Palestine itself. Jews in the diaspora mostly spoke Greek in the West and Aramaic in the East, while in Palestine, Hebrew and Aramaic were common, though Greek was also widespread. Culturally, Jews in the diaspora were a small minority among their pagan neighbors, while in Israel, they were the majority. Ideological differences were significant, especially regarding how to respond to the cultural challenge of Greco-Roman culture and Roman rule. In Palestine, Jewish groups like the Sadducees, Pharisees, Essenes, and Zealots had political and religious differences. These factors generated a large amount of literature in both Hebrew and Greek, which, along with archaeological evidence, forms the basis of our current knowledge. While Torah was a symbol of unity, it was also a source of contention among different groups. There was no firm agreement on what constituted the Torah or which writings were considered scripture. The Samaritans, centered in Shechem, and the Sadducees, centered in the Jerusalem temple, recognized only the five books of Moses as authoritative. In Alexandria, the Hellenistic Jew Philo focused almost exclusively on the Law of Moses, though he was aware of other writings. At Qumran, the Essenes recognized both the Law and the Prophets and wrote many of their own texts. The Pharisees had the most flexible view, including the Law, the Prophets, the writings, and their very own oral Torah. There was also diversity in the versions of scripture used. In the Western diaspora, the Hebrew text had been translated into Greek by 250 BC. This translation, known as the Septuagint, was considered divinely inspired by Hellenistic Jews. In Palestine, Hebrew was used in synagogue worship and study, but the appearance of Aramaic targums, or interpretive translations, suggests that Hebrew was not well known to many worshippers. Jews in the first century also interpreted their scriptures in different ways. Our knowledge of this is based on existing literature. For example, Philo of Alexandria read the Septuagint like a Greek philosopher, seeking moral lessons and using allegory to find deeper meanings. The
Pharisees. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.